In April of last year, Microsoft officially revealed the pricing structure for Windows 10's Extended Security Updates (ESU) program in a blog post on its website. This announcement detailed how businesses and organizations could continue receiving critical security updates beyond Windows 10's official end-of-support date. Recently, Microsoft has made updates to that original blog post, refining the documentation with additional pricing details and more comprehensive information. If you're a business or commercial user who relies on Windows 10 and intends to extend security support, it's crucial to review these latest changes. To help clarify, let's go over some key details from the updated Frequently Asked Questions (FAQ) section. How much does the Windows 10 ESU cost? According to Microsoft, businesses can now purchase the Windows 10 Extended Security Updates through the Microsoft Volume Licensing Program. The pricing starts at $61 per device for the first year. However, the cost will double each subsequent year for up to 3 years, meaning businesses that continue using Windows 10 long-term will see a significant increase in costs. For organizations using cloud-based solutions, there's good news. Windows 10 virtual machines running in Windows 365 or Azure Virtual Desktop will receive ESU at no extra cost. Additionally, any Windows 10 devices that connect to Windows 365 cloud PCs will also qualify for up to 3 years of free ESU as long as they maintain an active Windows 365 subscription license. So, if you're planning to keep using Windows 10 as a business or enterprise user, Microsoft has set the pricing structure for extended security updates. Careful consideration is needed when deciding whether to invest in ESU or transition to a newer operating system. One of the most common questions regarding Windows 10 Extended Security Updates (ESU) is whether there is a minimum number of licenses that must be purchased. According to Microsoft, there is no bulk requirement. You only need to purchase a single license to access ESU for Windows 10. In other words, even if you're an individual user or a small business, you can buy just one license without needing to meet any larger quantity thresholds. Another frequently asked question is whether ESUs can be bought for a specific period, such as a few months instead of a full year. Microsoft has provided a clear stance on this. The Windows 10 ESU program operates strictly on an annual basis. Customers must purchase it for a full year at a time. There is no option to pay for a partial period such as 6 months. The first year of ESU coverage begins in November 2025, which means that's when customers must start making their initial purchases. Additionally, Microsoft has emphasized that ESU licenses are cumulative. This means that if you decide to enroll in the program in year two, you must also pay for year one, as the updates are structured sequentially and require prior coverage to continue receiving support. Now, another important consideration is when the ESU program will actually be available for purchase. Microsoft has stated that licensing for ESU will be accessible through volume licensing channels approximately 12 months before Windows 10 officially reaches the end of support. Since Windows 10 support ends in October 2025, this means the ESU program started rolling out in late 2024. At this point, businesses and individual users who want to extend security updates should start securing their licenses if they haven't already. With all this in mind, it's crucial to stay informed about the ESU program if you're planning to keep using Windows 10 beyond its official end of support date. These updates will ensure that your system remains protected from emerging security threats, and knowing the licensing details ahead of time can help you plan your transition smoothly. The next important question that comes to mind is, how long will security updates be available for Windows 10? According to Microsoft, PCs that are registered under a commercial or educational organization can continue to receive security updates for a maximum period of 3 years after Windows 10 officially reaches the end of its support lifecycle. However, once this extended support period ends, no further security patches will be provided. Another common concern is whether technical support is included in the Extended Security Updates (ESU) program. Microsoft has clarified that the ESU program does not come with standard technical support. However, if customers face any issues directly related to the ESU itself, Microsoft will provide assistance in resolving those specific challenges. This means that while security updates will be available, general troubleshooting or technical help outside of ESU issues will not be covered under this program. One final frequently asked question is, will Windows 10 PCs become non-functional if users do not opt for the ESU program? The straightforward answer is no. Windows 10 devices will not suddenly stop working after support ends. They will continue to function as usual, but Microsoft strongly recommends that customers upgrade their eligible devices to Windows 11 for a more secure and up-to-date computing experience. To make this transition smoother, Microsoft suggests using tools like Windows Auto Patch or Microsoft Intune to upgrade existing PCs or, alternatively, purchasing a new device that comes pre-installed with Windows 11. Of course, it is evident that Microsoft is actively pushing users toward buying new Windows 11 PCs, which some may find a bit strategic or even a little aggressive. Nonetheless, the company also highlights another option for users who may not wish to upgrade their hardware. Instead of purchasing a new PC, customers can opt for cloud-based solutions, such as Windows 365, which allows them to access a Windows 11 environment from any device through a cloud-powered PC. This approach provides flexibility while ensuring that users still benefit from the latest Windows experience without necessarily investing in new physical hardware. Starting October 14, 2025, Microsoft will officially discontinue several key services for Windows 10 versions that reach the end of their support cycle. This means users will no longer receive technical assistance, updates introducing new features, or crucial quality updates including security patches and reliability enhancements. We just wanted to bring you up to speed on this so we're all aware of what's coming. Additionally, on a related note regarding the end of support for Windows 10, Microsoft is introducing an Extended Security Updates (ESU) program specifically for consumers. This program will allow regular home users to extend support for an additional year by paying a fee of $30. That's all for now. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch you in the next one. Bye.